Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Welcome to Kingdom Fellowship. Appreciate you tuning in to our program today. I want to share about how the joy of the Lord is our strength. You know, we need to be thankful and be joyful. We need to focus and to see the good things that God is doing. We can be overwhelmed by the problems and the sufferings that are going on in this world. And even Jesus says we're going to have tribulation, we're going to have sorrow, we're going to have suffering. Things are going to happen that we don't understand, we don't have the answer. But there's joy because in the presence of God there's joy and gladness and pleasures evermore. God pours out His abundant favor and blessings upon the children of God whose heart affections is towards Him. You know, we're in this world, we want to have the best that this world can offer, but we're not of the world, and my hope and my joy does not come from what this world can give me. I'm thankful for what the prosperity and the blessing that God has put upon my life and family's life, but it's the joy of the Lord that is my strength. The joy that I've learned by being in relationship. I received, for some reason, I've received grace and favor and anointing and power. It says, as many as receive Him gave he them power to become sons of God. So in a sense, we need to be born from above because this world is got sorrow and troubles and tribulation. But the new birth opens us up into a new realm of understanding that we see where our destiny and our future is in Christ, and that when we die, life is not over. We're going into a new life. Our new life begins because we're going into to be with the resurrected Christ. He is our hope. Our anchor is in the resurrected Christ. He's no longer in the grave. He rose from the grave. He's no longer suffering, but He's seated at the right hand of the Father. Even Stephen, when he was being stoned, all of a sudden the heavens opened up and he saw Jesus standing. He saw the glory of God and the power of God. He saw Jesus standing at the right hand of the Most High, at the right hand of God the Father. And that's where we're going to be. We're going to be in the heavenly places. We're going to be in the throne. We're going to be in paradise with Jesus when we leave this body. And, you know, and it's not just waiting till we die that we have the peace and the joy. Jesus says, my peace I leave you, my joy I give you, not as this world can give. This world can only, you can be happy with a new car, being married, a child, but all of a sudden, the newness wears off and you're complaining. And that's what happened to Israel. God did a mighty miracle in their lives, set them free from the most powerful influence ruling nation, Egypt. He brought them out in a mighty demonstration of God's power, and they went through the Red Sea and the Egyptians' armies were destroyed. See, God destroys the work of our past. There's no going back. That's been destroyed. That life, that bondage has been broken, and we pass through the waters of baptism, that we die to the old man. You know, we don't want to resurrect the old man. The old man, that old life, that old lifestyle and sinful desires are dead. They're buried with Christ. They're buried in the Red Sea at the water of baptism. We've obtained a good conscience through looking to Jesus, looking to the salvation, to the promise. See, we're looking forward to the promise of God, to the blessings of God. We're not looking back to the past, to the pleasures of Egypt and sin, because you can't have both. You can't serve God and you can't serve the lust of your flesh. You can't serve the old life. You have to choose who you're going to serve. Because out of your mouth, out of the issues of your heart, comes life. The choices that you make are in your heart, what the desires of your heart. And when our hearts are not right, we need to cry out to God, save me. Save me from the sin that is trying to grasp hold of me. But if I hold on to the Word of God, the seed, just a small Word of God, has the power to bring deliverance and to healing, to set the captives free. And we're going to be looking in the book of Isaiah tonight, just for a few minutes. We want to go over Isaiah chapter 63. You know, the God put into my heart that suffering and sorrows may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. There's a joy of the Lord. If we put aside what's going on around us and just be still, quiet yourself, and look to the Lord, pray to the Most High God and worship and put on a song, put on a song, a gospel song, a worship song, turn to the God TV or something and just worship God. Just worship Him in spirit and truth. Just say, Lord, I don't understand, but Lord, touch my life, change my life, intervene, step in to my life and bring a healing, give me understanding, take me out from the grip. It's like the enemy is like gripping and tear and pulling people down. You know, it's like a drowning man. You know, sometimes we don't want to have to be where we have to wait till they finally give up. You know, if you go in too early for someone who's drowning, they'll tear you apart. You need to know when they're willing, and they're willing and they're going to be obedient to the new way. And that's what happens. A lot of people perish because they're trying to do things in their own strength. They think they can make it, but it's really God. It's really the Lord who's with us. God before us, who can be against us? Meaning the obstacles, the enemy's plans are not going to pull you down any longer, but we're going to rise up in a renewed power, a renewed strength. And that's the joy in knowing that old life, that life of sin, that life of failure has been removed. The stone has been rolled away, the reproach. But now the joy of knowing, when you're going to receive a gift, when you're receiving a blessing, when you receive a new vacation down to Aruba or the Caribbeans or wherever your favorite place is, when you receive that gift, you have great expectations of having a good time. And that's what God wants you to realize, that you're going to have a good time in the presence of God, in the house of God. Those who give themselves to God are going to have a good time because the joy of the Lord is there. The praises of God. We're going to praise God because when you start looking to God, good things start happening. And we choose ye this day who you're going to serve. The blessings of God come upon us because we choose to live for God, to honor God, to worship Him. And the blessings overcome. It's like the waves. The waves keep coming for a period of time, but then the peace of God. And there's a blanket of peace God wants to bring and a joy into your life that you can be rest assured that you're in the house. You're in that place where God wants you to be, and He's going to keep you in that secret place, in the presence of God, where God has got a hold of your life, and He's going to direct your steps. He's going to bring the thoughts and direction in your mind. It doesn't come through crazy ideas, but it's God speaking into our hearts and our minds, and we learn to follow His ways. We learn to follow, and we know we're on the path of righteousness because we're walking like Jesus. It's like they say, what would Jesus do? Well, if we do what is right, we know that God will order our steps and work things out according to His plan, that He's got a plan for good. Okay, so Isaiah, we're going to read here, 61st chapter of Isaiah, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted and to proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of the prisons to them that are bound. And that's what God is. God is saying He's opening the prisons. Well, we don't see natural prisons. I remember when I was growing up, I was saying I was living in a prison, an invisible prison, bound by sin, bound by fears. I was afraid to express myself. I was afraid to even ask questions. You know, I enjoy playing sports, and I had some abilities with golfing. I won a lot of tournaments and trophies in baseball and golf when I was young. But I had an inferior complex. I strove outwardly and abounded and tried to prove myself, but it didn't give me a security, because I had to be free. And I remember saying, when am I going to get free from this torment and this fear and enjoy life? And that's what happens when I became born again. When I received Jesus, the fear and the anxiety, the worries, just rolled off. It says, cast your burdens upon the Lord. Give him your cares, because he cares and he loves for you, and he's going to help direct your path, and you know you're going to succeed. It says, Joshua, he told Joshua, you're going to succeed. I know you're trying to compare yourself to Moses, to other people, but God's saying, listen to my voice. Pay attention to the word that I bring you through, and as you study and meditate and put your affections and your desires upon me, I will order your steps, and every step you take, every decision that you make, you're going to find the blessings and the success. That's the key word we need in life. You need success. You need to look to Jesus, and God will open the creativity. He says he opens the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing. It's not where you're going to have Dunkin' Donuts come down to your table. The ability to gain wealth, the new ideas, the blessings of God, you're going to have the influence to motivate people to make decisions and to see things happen that weren't happening before. So we see here that God is opening the prisons, those inhibitions, those fears, those limitations. We limit God because we don't have a vision that's beyond our own lifestyle. We've been comfortable in this little sphere, but God's saying, I want your vision to go beyond your abilities, beyond your four walls, and step into the promises of God, because in the promises of God is where you're going to find that rest. You're going to find that peace. You're going to find that success in life, because you're entering into the promises because you have faith. Basically, you know, the minister's been telling me, faith is just having confidence to face life, having confidence that you're going to succeed. And that's what makes the difference. It's just having the confidence and knowing what you decide, what decisions you've made, you're going to succeed. That you've been equipped and you've been qualified, that God is going to provide all your needs. You know, it's like a lot of times with me, I don't prepare a lot of times what I'm going to say. God says, just open your mouth and I'm going to fill it. I'll give you the words to speak, because my words are going to come forth and they're going to bring life. They're going to bring encouragement and strength to the people who have ears to hear, because there's a famine. Everybody wants to hear a great story, but what happens is when there's no change in your life, when you don't have the ability to succeed, you don't have the courage you need to open the door and step out and face the problems. And that's what my pastor in Canada told me. He says, Pete, there's problems you need to face. You can't avoid every problem. You just need to know you're going to succeed. You're going to find the answer. You're going to resolve all the problems in life, and you're going to go on, and you're going to just, it's this, the doors are going to open. You're going to have success. And that's what God wants you to have, a confidence, knowing that you have been appointed. You've been chosen by God to do this calling, to do this work, to succeed in life, to provide for your family, to have a healthy, loving relationship with your wife, your family, your kids, with God. How can we say we love God when we don't have the ability to love and have a healthy relationship with other people? It says, out of the abundance of your heart, a tree bears fruit naturally. A tree produces apples, figs, whatever it is. Your life, if it's really rooted in Christ, will produce life, produces the blessings of God. People are going to see it. All of a sudden, your finances are working out. The relationships are working out. People are learning to get along with you. Of course, you're going to have what they say, on the average, you have 10% of enemies. People just don't like you just because of the way you look or the way you sound. You can't please everybody, but the whole thing is, when you have the goods, when you have the anointing, it says here, you've been it says, because he has anointed me. That means he's chosen me. He's chosen you, and he's abiding upon you. Because why? You've chosen him. If my word, Jesus says, if the word of God abides in you, then he's abiding with you because you've made a choice to receive him. And you received an anointing, this spiritual anointing, this new life, this new ability that's living in me. I'm spiritually alive now. Now I can understand the manual. The blinders have been removed. The manual, I've been given the understanding, the key has been opened, and I'm able to understand the manual, and God's able to give me the secrets of the kingdom. And that's what Jesus says. You people hear what I'm saying. You see the words, but you can't understand what's going on. It's still a mystery because you need to receive Jesus. You need to be born again. Your life needs to be opened up to God. When you receive him, you receive power to understand the mysteries of the kingdom in order to have the receive and walk in this way. You start to think the way that he thinks. Just as my son, he thinks the way that I think because it's been passed down. The blessings of God, the freedom, the liberty has been passed down. And the freedom is being passed down through the presence of God. God is releasing a presence and a joy through these teachings. And we want you to take a hold of it. Just write us, call us up, and we want to pray and believe God is anointing you. And you need to know you're anointed because the anointing is going to teach you all things. You're going to hear a lot of things from other people and not going to make any sense. You're not going to be able to put it into practice. But when you have confidence that the anointing is upon you, that because you received Jesus, and now he says, follow me. And the steps that you make, the decisions, the thoughts that start coming into your mind, you're going to succeed, and they're going to cause you to enter into the promised land and bring the blessings of God into your life, into your family, into other people's life. And that's what God spoke to Joshua. He had a visitation from God, and then he knew it wasn't whether or not if he was with him or what, but he says, you need to follow me. If you join yourself to me, then I will lead you into success. You'll go into the promised land. And that's how people hear about the promises, but they can never take hold of the blessings. Their life is still the same because you haven't fully received. It has to become your life, my strength. I know I'm not going to be held back. It's like the woman who says, my daughter is vexed with a devil. My son is sick. I need your healing touch. And even Jesus said to her, bread is for the children. I can't give the blessings to the dogs, to the Gentiles. But when you know that God has something for your life, something better for your life, you're going to break out of the lies and anything that holds you back because God's got a plan for good for your life. These promises are for your life and they're yea and amen for as many as receive them. To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all those who mourn, to appoint unto them all that mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes and the oil of joy for mourning, and the garments of praise for the spirit of, he's given us the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. So when you receive the joy, so we've been appointed and accepted that the works of the devil, Jesus came to what? Destroy the works of the devil, to set us free from the prisons, those fears and inhibitions, and to enter into the promises of God, and that we've been given beauty. He shares His beauty and His life. That's why you need to see Him. When you see Him, you know what you have. When you know who you are, for as many as know Him, they have power to do great exploits, it says. They did great exploits because they knew Him. Moses had his encounter with God. He knew Him at the bush. God spoke to him and says, go. When you have an experience with God, you know that you know that God is with you, and you go forth in a confidence and a power. You go forth in the joy, knowing that you're going to succeed. And all of a sudden, the problems in life don't get you down because you're praising God, even though nothing's changed. You're praising God because you know you have the victory. Things are going to work out. Everything is going to be tossed aside. The problem solved because God has the answer. God has the answer. The yes and amen. So the Spirit of the Lord just lifts, removes the heaviness. That's the doubts, the fears, the failure. They disappear. It's like a vapor. When the sun comes, the morning mist dissolves. Those are the failure mentality. Every fear and doubt just dissolves when you come in the presence of God. When you have the joy of the Lord. And we want to share more about these scriptures. You know, and I'm writing daily and I'm putting things up on the blog. We got a new blog out there called NY New York Place, nyplace.org. You can go to the old website. We're still maintaining that, godspace.cc, personalgrace.com, and we're also on Twitter and we're on Facebook. And you want to, I have these daily words. I'm writing every day and I'm sharing revelation and experience. And you need to have a relationship with God. You need to be in the presence of God. And I'm sharing this. This is from Wednesday the 17th. Is what? Just yesterday, I'm sharing this, and God's put this on my heart. I'm putting this out to people. You can get on my mailing list. Just email me. Call us up, 631-834-4796, whatever number's on the screen. Love the Lord your God with all your heart. It says, sorrow may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. We all live with sacrifices and suffering, but our God delivers us from them all. For when we come out of the times of suffering, it is not in our own strength, but in the love and in the strength of the Lord. Out of these sorrows comes a deep love for God and a renewed relationship. We come in a love and a strength that the Lord can give us. We come out of the wilderness leaning upon the breast of the Lord. We become so dependent upon Him during these hard times that He becomes are all and all. We don't understand why we went through these horrific events, but all that matters now is that I know that He is with me. When I know my God is with me, He's renewed the relationship. He's taken a hold of my life now. When I know He's with me, and I have attached myself to my Lord and Savior, the lover of my soul, I have clinged to Him. I have found comfort in His everlasting arms. And these are the daily word I'm putting out on the web, on Twitter and on Facebook. You need to get hooked up. You need to get connected, plugged in to the source, to what God is releasing through this ministry. I want to pray. We thank You, Lord, to bring a healing and deliverance, bring strength, bring that joy, that beauty for ashes into the homes of Your people. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray it. In Jesus' name, it's done.